Hi you guys, it's Jessica here. I have a few things to show you, dolly related, and some fun things. I think the first thing I'll start with is this Delf head, this Delf boy head. Some of you may have saw this. ResinWonders had him on her channel. She's raising money for sculpting and casting her own doll, which I always think sounds really interesting.
I couldn't resist this boy.
He is a he's an event head. He's the Delf Nanuri 2007 Lutz CP Delf, and he has the original company face up, which that was one of the things when she was showing him in her video. I just loved that face up so much, and when I found out it was the original, I thought that was really special. So he has the elf ears, and he's got some little fangs, little vampire teeth, I guess is what they call them, and he is just wonderful. I still have an old Lutz boy, Delf boy body on layaway, and I can't wait to be able to finish off that so that I can bring it home for him, because he's a pretty boy. She also sent these, can't really see them with the lighting. They're really pretty, like magenta, purple, glass eyes, one of my favorite colors, but she sent those along too. That was very, very nice. She also sent some other goodies, which I was pretty darn excited about. So I have Amergen, who is modeling these. So these are a pair of resin horns, and they're so awesome. When I saw that she had included these, I was just so excited. It was such an unexpected and very appreciated gift. But I remember when she got these, she had a video a while back, quite a while ago. She'd gone to a doll show in Japan and gotten these resin horns, and thereby, this is his card or their card. It says Mix Candy. But anyways, their shop is not, the website's closed down. And then it came with this too, which I can't read what that says. I remember when she had on her video, or maybe it was Instagram or both, I can't remember, that she had showed these horns, and I'd been really interested in them then. And I think even at this time, I don't think that they were available. I don't think that they had their shop open or were offering them really. So that's really special. And I don't know if she remembered that I like those, or just because I have a lot of dolls that have horns and antlers, but for whatever reason, thank you so much, Liz. These are just really amazing, and Amergen has claimed them. Yes, they go through his hat, okay? I think they do really suit him very well. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with them. And I really like how they're painted. They look like they've been airbrushed black, and then they have these kind of gold metallic paint airbrush tips and a little bit at the base too, and I just love that. Maybe I'll paint those really awesome Irish elk antlers that way. I think they would look really neat that way. I still need to work on those. Maybe more painting can happen this spring, this summer, when it's been raining for days, and it's just that time of year where it just does that. So, yeah, pretty, this guy is very handsome, and I'm really glad to add him to my Delf family. And she also sent these candies. As you can see, I've already broken into them. I don't know what they say. I'm assuming there's some sort of Easter candy, They're very cute. They're these little, I love the packaging though. They're these little white, I would describe them as chocolate malt balls, but they're a little bit harder, but still easy to chew. But the packaging is very cute. Look at, they have like little bunny on the wrapper. If you can see that. It's very adorable. Very adorable. Okay. But thanks again, Liz. Thank you very much. That really made my day opening that package. That was very nice. I have some sewing pieces to show you guys that I've been working on and some projects that I've been doing for my dolls. I finished, well, actually it's not quite finished. I haven't put the snaps in the back. There's some pins holding it together here. But I just need to put the snaps in the back. This dress I made for Lily. She is my Lily Cat Cerise Dolls Lilis. I can never say it. But I got this fabric, The Quilting Bee, which is a high-end quilting store in town that has really expensive fabrics. They're actually moving to another building, so they had a lot of things on sale. Still, even with the sale, I think I only got like a half a yard of this, and it was like, yeah, it was definitely a bit of a splurge. But I got this fabric with the idea that I was going to make some collared shirts with it, but I was really in a dressmaking mood. I really wanted to make some dresses. So I made this one. I don't know if you can see. Let me see if I can. The window is right there, if we can come into the light a little bit. There's pin tucks in the front, and it has. So this is a satin fabric that I make my own ribbons out of, because I can never find this color of ribbons. So I have to kind of like make them myself. But it's got a ruffle at the bottom. The bodice is fully lined. And this hat, which I made ages ago, actually has the same color of ribbon in it, and it goes really good with her little short hairstyle. And she's wearing these are some boots that I got off of Dollmore. I'm pretty sure I got it off the Dollmore eBay website a while ago now, but they fit Lily Cats really well. So just to show you guys, anything that fits Lily Cats MSD dolls usually fits Minifees too. So if you wanted to try to find those, there may be maybe a little on the big side, but I find with boots that matters less. They stay on and they look pretty proportionate. So just, I like to show those things because I know people are always looking for shoes for their Minifees. So those fit pretty good. I had a lot of fun. I love doing pin tucks. I haven't been in the mood for a long time to sew dresses, and I've had a lot of girl dolls that really need things, and not that they can't have pants and things like that, but I just was a lot more interested in sewing like men's shirts and vests and style pants for men's bodies, basically. So you do have to change things if there's boobs involved and waist and things like that. So there's Lily, and I'm really happy with the colors. They go well for her. So I basically adjusted the same pattern, and let me grab her at another bed here, and I made a similar type of design dress for this girl. This is Amelia, and she is on the Feeple 60 Moe body, if I said that right. And I am really happy to have worked with her. When I opened this body and put her head on, pretty much in the same day, I put on this Siona full set outfit that I had gotten, the Fairyland full set outfit, which is amazing. It's beautiful. I put it on her immediately, and then that was kind of it. And I absolutely loved how she looked. I loved the body, but it really, like, I didn't really do anything after that. And for me, I've found that it's really helped me to feel more connected to my dolls and get to know them better by sewing them things. So she never got that chance. So it was nice to be able to do this and make her this outfit, and the colors and the kind of things are just, you know, they just say Amelia to me. It was very fun to be able to do that. But it's the same type of design, really. It's just increased in size. It's pin tucks in the front. I made a ribbon out of some satin. I added beading down the front, but I also added it all the way around. Nothing too complicated, just a little line of pretty golden beads. And I made her some tights, which are actually, they're a little too long, so I have to push them up. They're a little bit too long. I could probably pull them down and cut them off, but I kind of wanted the option to be able to use them for another doll that's taller if I wanted to. So they'll just get pushed up. But I like these boots go a lot better, I think, with this outfit than they did with the Siona set. And these little Moe, they're very short and squat feet, and they're very different in shape from the Delph girls. They're very different. And I should do a body comparison at some point, because the bodies are very different, and things that I sew for one don't necessarily fit the best. The Delph body is definitely a lot slimmer, just slimmer and longer is what I would say, though height wise they're probably very same, but she's rounder. The Moe body is rounder. So it definitely makes a difference with shoes and more tighter fitting things. You can really tell the difference. But just this, the posability of this body, it's phenomenal. I have the Moe, the mini Fee Moe body back there, and then the Feeple 60 Moe body. These have got to be they're probably the best posing bodies that I own. They're really phenomenal. And then I have the male Moe version body, and it's great. They are really, really good posing bodies. If they were more available, then I probably would be getting more of them. Because I really do like them a lot. I really enjoy these bodies. But I think Amelia is looking really pretty, really enjoying her look in her new outfit. So I've been in a dress sewing mood, and so tackled some other dresses that I'll show you here. Pop off your head cap. So I made, I'll start with this gal. This is my CP Delph Miu. I made her a new little outfit. She's actually wearing a flower crown. I think this is her Les flower crown. She's wearing this right now. I'll put in a picture here. I'll put in a picture that shows this underdress skirt. It's almost like a big shirt, basically, but it functions as a skirt. I'll put in a picture because I don't want to take the corset off. But anyways, it's a fairly simple design. It takes a lot of time just because there's a lot of gathers, and it takes up a lot of fabric, but it's not an overly complicated design. But the main purpose of this is I wanted something that would look nice underneath a corset, with the idea of where that the have a corset over it or an underbust corset, and it would look fitted and be have a lot of volume and gathers. So this is did I show this in the last video? I can't remember. Maybe I did. If I did, I'm sorry. Here we go again. This is my first attempt at sewing a, I did show this last time, didn't I? Yeah. This was my first attempt at making a corset, for dolls, making a corset. And it's, so there's lots of things that aren't right about it, but the things that are good is that it fits good. I do think it has a really good fit. And things that I need to work, I need to find some eyelets that function better, that are more finished, and I do have smaller ones, but they were less finished, so this was my first attempt, and it actually worked out not too bad. I actually am pretty happy with that. So I decided to work on the corset some more, and I wanted something for this gal. So this is Alondria. She is my twiggling ingenue. She's the sleeping head. And so I made her the same type of dress design. It's the same design, really. I think I did maybe the arms, the gathers a little bit. There's ruffles here instead of just being a cuff. So that's a little bit different. But basically the same kind of bodice design. And I'll put in a picture. I think I have a picture of the underdress. If I do, I'll stick it in here, because I don't want to take the corset off. But I wanted to make a corset out of this stretchy faux suede. It's this green faux suede, which I've made some vest out of. And again, I don't like my eyelets. I wish I could. I broke my eyelet setters. I was trying to put some smaller ones in. I was doing some practice ones and I totally like jammed it. And I think I bent the inside of it. So it wasn't very expensive. You get it from AliExpress for like $13. Don't buy the ones at like Hobby Lobby for $40. You can get them from AliExpress for much cheaper, but you have to wait a month for them to come in. So now I have to order another one of those and wait forever to come in. So I'm a little bit bummed. But I do think I did end up getting, you know, something that she could wear. I'm not to the point where I would be offering to make corsets for people in any way. I still have a lot of work to do. I think that this could have really benefited from some boning to help keep its shape, because you can see it kind of, because a corset is supposed to be, it's supposed to be stiff. It's supposed to be form-fitting and stiff, and it has wrinkles, and when she moves, it kind of crinkles up. So it's not, corsets aren't supposed to do that. So it needs some work, but I'm happy with the progress I've been making. You know, I think that, you know, this is my second time sewing a corset. I think getting it to actually fit her properly, that part is going pretty well. Figuring out how to get them to fit right. And that's a size as I go type of thing. So I wouldn't want to sew one for a doll that I didn't have in front of me, basically. I need a doll to sew it around and drape it on and try it out and stuff as I'm going. So, I think it goes really good with her red boots, kind of this color family. It's lined, pull up a piece of it there, in this, in that same colored red maroon, burgundy colored satin. And I managed not to melt the suede. I was really good at not melting the suede, which I've been having problems with, but I had the iron so low too, and it absolutely singed the satin. There's a part in the side where it's got a pretty good singe on it, so so we're still working on these things. But this is what I'd really like to do, is maybe make some corsets that are out of suede and faux suede, faux leather, things like that. I think that would be I would like those for my own dolls, and there's probably maybe other people that would like that too, but that's the back. And then this wig. So the story of this wig. This is the first wig I've ever cut. I cut this last night. I finally got the courage to do it. You can see it's probably it's a little crooked, isn't it? But this wig was, I am not even kidding you, it was 70 centimeters long. I think I've showed it in a video and pictures before. I got it from my friend Miss Mantis, and she had it for ages, and then she sent it on to me, and it's just gorgeous. It's utterly gorgeous. But to actually keep it on your doll and use it for anything besides like some photo shoots, the weight of it, it's so heavy that it would just pull right off of the doll. It was impossible to keep it from being untangled, just instantly would become tangled, it's just too long. So I got up the courage to finally cut it, and I'm so glad that I did, because I'm very, very happy with it now. I think it suits her very well. She's meant to have white hair, and it's very sleek. It lays very flat, and I really love it. I think it's just perfect. It's just exactly what I wanted for her. So I wish I would have done that a long time ago, but everything's a process, isn't it? Okay. I do have some other little things that I wanted to show you. I think I'll show this one thing and then we'll kind of go around, because I've been working on some little diorama sets. They're not finished, but I kind of wanted to show what I've been working on. Okay, I did want to show, for people who have the mini ingenue, I wanted to show that these shoes fit. These are a pair of pumps. They come in brown, white, and black. They are on the Dollmore eBay website, or Dollmore eBay, I should say, and they fit really, really well. So I just wanted to show those on her. They fit really good. So I think the last I checked, the white were out of stock, unfortunately, because I'd really like to get those. But I wanted people that have mini ingenues to know that that does fit. Okay, so I think I'm going to grab the camera and flip it around, because it'll be easier to show things that way. So we'll be right
okay.
back.
Okay. So I've been working on my little diorama scenes, and I like how this one is looking right now, because I just got this last week. I picked up some of these little fairy lights. They're little tiny LED string lights. I've been wanting some for a long time, and I was in Target getting some other things and they had some. So I went ahead and pick these up, and I just think that they're so magical. I really do want to start working on some little mini diorama areas on some of these shelves. I don't have a ton of props, but I have some things, and it'd be nice to kind of display and use those things. This is my doll in mind, Lorena Head. She's on a Doll Chateau kid body, and doll in mind, Marley, on an old Doll Zone boy body. And it's my little Resin Soul dog and my Sakura bunny. This wonderful little bust portrait done by Sleetwealth. This is what she does. This is what Sleetwealth does, is makes these wonderful portraits, and this one is very tiny and intricate, and I just love it. It needed a special place to be displayed like this. So there's that, and I do have some other spots that are in progress. They're not finished, just some little areas for MSD and smaller size dolls that it'd just be kind of a nice way to display some of them. Let's see. Oh, I wanted to show you this situation right here. As you can see, Lear is on his
Doll Chateau body right now. And Woden is still on the Long Soul body, which is supposed to be for Sion, who is over here. Poor guy, poor guy. Anyways, I don't know. I don't see this situation remedying itself. I'm kind of thinking, you know, down the line, later this year, next year, that I would like to get a different body for Sion. And what I'd really like is to get him a tan body of some kind and then blush him to match it. So sometime that will happen, because I don't think Woden does not want to give this body up. He has demanded to stay on here. I also wanted to show this one kind of fell, didn't it? I put these horns. I think these are resin soul horns. I can't remember. I got them a long time ago. But this amazing Tsum lion mask that Cern has been wearing. I put these are his horns. These were meant to be his horns, and I never did paint them or do anything with them. But I think they look really cool with this mask. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys that. But this is another little area that I'm working on. Just making some cute little areas. And I want to do a bunch more down here. Put some little mini pictures and wallpaper up and really make this look really cute too. And then I have, pardon my mess here, this is all my fabric. I was sorting through a bunch of things. This is another area that that I want to put together and make it a nice little place for like little photo areas and things like that. So, okay. Gosh, this front facing camera is much nicer, isn't it? I just wanted to get one more view of Elandria and Amergen because I am so happy with how they're looking, and these awesome horns. Oh yeah, you can see them a lot better. Also the sunlight. I opened the window so that we could have some sunlight for the movie. But I am so, so happy with them. I just wanted to add a little note here. I do need to make a video. I have opened up for sewing commissions, and I will be posting more details about that. It definitely isn't a free-for-all, order whatever you want and that sort of thing. It's a list of things that I will sew. So with a price list and kind of ideas and things like that. So I made a post to my Instagram with all the details, and I tried to post one up on BJD Addicts Sales and Commissions, but I couldn't find my listing. I don't know if they took it down or what the problem is there, but I can't find it. I'm not sure what the issue is. So I need to get something up on Den of Angels. So working on those things, and I don't know if it's going to happen this week, but hopefully in the next week or so, I'll get something posted up for you guys. So, all right. I hope you're having a great Monday, and I will see you guys around. Bye-bye.